What's he that wishes so? My cousin Westmoreland. No, my fair cousin. We are marked to die, we are enough to do our country loss. And if to live, the fewer men, the greater share of honor. God's will, I pray thee, wish not one man more. Nigel, I am not covetous for gold, nor care I who doth feed upon my cost. It yours may not have meant my garments wear, such helper things dwell not in my desires. But if it be a sin to covet honor, I am the most offending soul alive. No, faith, my cousin, wish not a man from England. Rather proclaim at Westmoreland through my host that he that hath no stomach to this fight, let him depart. His passport shall be made and crowns for convoy put into his purse. We would not die in that man's company that fears his fellowship to die with us. This day is called the Feast of Crispian. He that outlives this day and comes safe home will stand to tiptoe when this day is named, and rouse him at the name of Crispian. He that shall live this day and see old age will yearly on the vigil feast his neighbors and say, tomorrow is St. Crispian's. Then will he strip his sleeve and show his scars and say, these wounds I had on Crispian's day. Old men forget, yet all should be forgot, but he'll remember with advantages what feats he did that day. And shall our names, familiar in his mouth, his household words, Harry the King, Bedford and Exeter, Warwick and Talbot, Salisbury and Gloucester, be in their flowing cups freshly remembered. This story shall the good man teach his son, that Christmas, Christmas shall now go by from this day to the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. We few. We happy few. We band of brothers. For he today who sheds his blood with me shall be my brother, be he ne'er so vile. This day shall gentle his condition. Gentlemen in England now abed shall think themselves accursed they were not here, and hold their manhoods cheap. Well, any speaks that fought with us upon St. Crispin's Day.